Good morning, everyone. My name is Lee Kong Sang Nam, and here is my teammate Peter Kong Sisu. We are students from Professor Dua Kong Science High School, Drang. Today, we would like to present our science project on the title of Types of Mosquito Larvae Predators and Factors Influencing Their Abundance in Drang Province. Well, nowadays, there are many mosquito-borne viruses around the world, and almost all of the virus is transmitted by the mosquitoes. So it's very, very dangerous for people. From this map, the red area means high risk area of the mosquito borne viral disease. And you can see that Thailand is in the high risk area of mosquito borne viral disease too. The worst is malaria, which kills more than 600,000 people each every year. And the fastest spreading disease is dengue. It threatens the half of the world's populations and it causes the spending much of the dollars for the dengue treatment. And also another disease too, like chikungunya lymphatic filariasis, Japanese encephalitis and Zika. Here is the table of the disease and the vectors. We can see that in Thailand we often found the Calyx, Aedes, Meissonia and Amygdalus mosquitoes. Mostly we found the breeding site of the mosquitoes around the house, and we can find many mosquito larvae in many types of container like in the pictures. And we also found the predators, the creatures which eat mosquito larvae as a food. And we also found them around the house too. And maybe you know that some kind of the mosquito larvae is a predator too. That's so weird, but it's so true. And I think it's very amazing. So we study our project. Here's our objective. First, study effects of predators of mosquito larvae on the species and the number of mosquito larvae. And second, study effects of water qualities on the species and the number of mosquito larvae. And here is our research question. First, does predator of mosquito larvae affect the species and the number of the mosquito larvae? And second, does water qualities affect on the species and the number of the mosquito larvae? Our study site was conducted in Mekdang, Southern Thailand. We chose only two sub-districts, Mekdang and Hasamran, and we collect 60 households per sub-district, so we totally collect about 120 households. We start our project from first set the study site, then we go to each study site and collect all the mosquito larvae from both indoor and outdoor container and collected them in the plastic bag and then preserved them in 90% ethanol. After that, we identified the mosquito larvae under the microscope. And finally, we submit the data and on the global website. We studied the water qualities such as pH, temperature, TDS, and conductivity. After we put the data on the Globe website, we input the data into the analysis Microsoft Excel and analyze them with the SPSS. Here is the statistical analysis that we use for our project. We use percentage, t-test, Spearman.
Our results, we studied the number of predators in with and without mosquito larvae. This table shows number and type of predator in the continents with and without mosquito larvae. There are 11 types of predators, and the most identified is fish, about 43.57%, and the second we found two water beetle, about 31.04%, and we also found Toxolepis species 2. Is this a mosquito larvae that can eat another species? Next, we study the difference in the number of mosquito larvae we between with and without predators. From this graph shows the number of mosquito larvae with and without predators. The purple bars stand for the number of mosquito larvae in the container without predators, and the gray bars stand for the number of mosquito larvae in the container with predators. We can see that the number of mosquito larvae in the container without predator is higher than the container without predators. And the prominence of species is at its own because. Next, we study the relationship between the number of mosquito larvae and predators. Show the number of mosquito larvae with the number of predators. If there are high the number of predators, the number of mosquito larvae will be low. It means that the number of mosquito larvae has negative correlation with the number of predators. Next, we study the difference in the water qualities in the container between with and without predators. This table shows the quality of water in the container with predator and without predator. We found that only TDS has significant difference between the container with predators and without predators. So it may be caused by the interactions between the between the mosquito larvae and the predators. The water is almost moving all the time, so TDS in the container with predator is higher than the container without predators. And last, we study types of container and the number of predators. We found the most number of predators in the plastic bucket. And our conclusions. First, we found 11 types of predator in our study size, and the most predator that we found is fish. Next, the number of mosquito larvae are negatively correlated with the number of predators. And we show that predators have a role in controlling the mosquito larvae. And we observe that TDS have effects on the difference between container with predator and without predators.
After we finish our work, we get knowledge from this and bring it back to the local committee. Let them know that predator is an important factor which can control the number of the mosquito larvae. And what kind of the animal which can be the predators. And if you have to store water around the house, I suggest predator. It can help you to eradicate the mosquito larvae around your house without using the chemical matter which can affect on your health. Remember that more predator, less chemical matter, less mosquito larvae, less disease, and happiness around the world.
Okay, thanks for all of us to help us to finish this project. Thank you for your kind attention.